Approximately 1,100 physically challenged young people are expected to take part in this year's Empire Games in Nassau County. But as Zavira Titler reports, budget cutbacks almost put an end to the 26-year-old competition.
State budget cutbacks have made it challenging to fund the Empire State Games for the physically challenged. However, Nassau County Executive Edmund Gano says he's stepping in to keep them going.
The collective efforts of those behind me have made certain that these games will continue here in Nassau County and help serve our physically challenged.
And through a committee to save the games, Mangano says he was able to get sponsors and private donations to fund the event, and the county executive says it's helping to give Nassau County residents what they want.
We have to hold on to certain programs that make people happy, and the games for the physically challenged make people happy. So
youngsters from 5 to 21 will compete in track, field, swimming, and wheelchair basketball at Mitchell Athletic Complex and Nassau Community College. And founder Susan Gordon Ryan says she's happy this 26-year tradition is continuing.
It's close to my heart because really I had polio as a child, and I was never involved in physical fitness as a child when I went to school because I was always excused because they didn't have adaptive phys ed. So I really kind of developed the program around my own experiences and what I did not participate in as a child.
The games will run from June 2nd through June 4th, and if you want to make donations to help with medals, uniforms, and transportation, you can go ahead and do that online at savethegames.org. In Uniondale, Severa Titler, LI News Tonight.